Yo, what's up, guys?
Sorry about that. What's up, guys? My name is Shay. Okay, Thompson Troy right here. And, well, let me tell you. Yes, you're watching Battlefield 3 gameplay. And yes, there is no audio for you today. But, anyway, guys. Yeah, I'm using UMP45, and this is a good gun. Real good gun. I mean, I like the guns in Battlefield 3. Because, like, well, I haven't tried a lot of them out. Tried some of the assault rifles, and there's so many to choose. So many weapons, kind of hard to choose. I mean, that's how I feel when I play Battlefield 3. What gun am I going to use today? What gun am I going to use for this game? Or next game? Or next game? So, I just chose the UMP45 out of nowhere. And I got some attachments. And you're going to see them pop up. And yeah, I didn't put no audio for you to hear. So, what I'm going to talk about, this is a new series I'm going to be doing. The Road to Battlefield 4. And hope I didn't say Battlefield 4 in the beginning of the video, so yeah, hope I didn't say that. But yeah, the Road to Battlefield 4, it'll be not that random, but let me talk about some stuff, probably objective, mostly objective, and some guns, some features, some different topics, and basically between Battlefield 3 and Battlefield 4, like what do we expect? I mean, what do we already have, and what do we expect? So yeah, so we're gonna be talking about those two for until Battlefield 4 comes out, or the beta comes out, and that's when my opinions will come out for that day. So when beta comes out, so but first beginning, so yes, I'm a fan of Battlefield 3 and I'm gonna be a fan of Battlefield 4, but true story, I haven't played the Battlefield series. Like, I didn't play Battlefield 2 or 1. That was like I didn't know about it, but I heard Battlefield Bad Company 2 and the new map pack for it, Vietnam. But that was when I wasn't feeling it. But when Battlefield 3 came out, I just decided, all right, I'm going to get this. It looks so good. Then I'm going to play the, well, and then I started to play the campaign. And I'm like, oh, wow. This blows my mind. Or it may be just all over my pants. Yeah. It had that moment. I had that moment when I just like playing this game. I mean, that was only when I played the campaign. So yeah, it was gonna blow my mind away because of the graphics and stuff. Even with that TV, that was when I had like a small HDTV ago. So yeah, I'm a Battlefield 3 fan. And the best part for me is that there are no killstreaks. So I'm not gonna be like the person that races a lot. And like, if I'm gonna have a killstreak, I'm gonna be saying, oh, wow, I'm gonna have a killstreak. Yes, almost there. And then next thing you know, screw my life. No, that's the whole point for me. Like, I can play this game. I don't have to worry about killstreaks because the stuff are going to be on the ground. Well, if you're in, like, let's see, Rush. If you're on Rush or Conquest Domination or Squad Domination. Yeah, there are two different types of domination. It's, like, surprising for me because Squad Domination is, like, four people. Let's see, a 24p. Oh, wow. I cannot imagine it because I haven't played Squad Domination. So, yeah, I really do not want to try that. So, and yes, there are a lot of guns in Battlefield 3. And there are going to be more guns in Battlefield 4 as well, too. Some that we didn't see, or probably we did see. But, I mean, well, more of them that we didn't see, or we did not even exactly see. So, yeah. But I will, like, there's gonna be other videos that I'm gonna be talking about the gun breakdowns and stuff. Like, I'm just gonna do stuff, like, I'm gonna take some time and look over some stuff for Battlefield 4, and then I'm gonna do like a commentary after that. So, yeah, the graphics for Battlefield 3 is, it's getting there, it's good. Good, real good. Some people don't realize the graphics. But mostly a lot of people would see the graphics because, I mean, yeah, it does have good graphics. And when, like, some brightness and stuff, the render, like, I look at the trailer. Like, I did a video 2 or 1 year. I think it was a year ago. Yeah, no, right. I was right, 2 years ago. Talking about the graphics, the render, the weapon, the customization, the brightness, and the dynamics. Well, kind of dynamics. But I was wanting the in the campaign, I meant to say dynamics in the campaign in that video, but dynamics in Battlefield 4, oh man, it's gonna be real crazy. because the graphics gonna be like more the same, but there's gonna be like more texture to it, and the light, the brightness is gonna be like completely good. Like, there's so many stuff that I cannot really say because it's gonna make me blow my mind, or if I even try to look at it, imagine it, or hopes about it, there's gonna be a lot of jizz in my pants if I can't even get this right. I mean, can't even stop thinking about it. It's like thinking about a girl, but never mind about saying that. So yeah, Battlefield 4 is gonna be fun, the same fun as Battlefield 3. This thing, I kid you not, Battlefield 3, it was fun. And if you think this was more fun, then Battlefield 4 will be the same thing. But, and people like usually take it like, objective seriously. Like, let's say in team deathmatch, you really want to win, you need like a team. Yes, it's gonna be like the same thing like that. Because Battlefield 3, it was good. There were some glitches, but no worries about that. Just that, yeah, Battlefield 3 is gonna be fun and more gonna be objective. But the map, however, that thing's gonna be crazy. So I already talked about better graphics. Like, Battlefield 4 already has better graphics because we've already seen it at the E3. The multiplayer, the campaign, we've seen it at the Microsoft Xbox conference the first time, and then at Microsoft Xbox conference at E3. Then that really got my attention at that campaign. Even the multiplayer, because of how that balloon came down, I was like saying, "Oh man, I need this. I want it. I'm gonna get it." But I almost made saying, "Well, Grand Theft Auto 5." But I'll talk about that one later. But yeah, that thing was ready to get me jizzing on my pants, cause how the building went down, and next thing the map changed. Even the tanks and stuff, and more destruction. Like how the road, there was a hole in the road and one of those bridges, and I'm saying, "Oh shoot!" Yeah. So yeah, destruction times two. It's like crazy. Commander mode, however, I'm thinking, all right, so we see that the iPad, the tablet, the Galaxy Tab, or Samsung Galaxy Tab. It's gonna be for iPhone or your Android. I don't know. Cause if it is, I'm not a really big fan of the iPad, because I really don't have one. I probably might get one sooner or later. But the Commander mode, however, it's like I really cannot explain that much, because like I think it was when you can tell your friends like to go to its objective and stuff, and like I'll do another video on Commander Mode, because like I'm not gonna talk about really that much about Commander Mode, because I know a little bit, but in another video I'm gonna like get some time to it and then talk about that, because I don't want to get y'all hate it and stuff. But yeah, Commander Mode is like kind of new. Like you have to control it, tell the AC-130 where to guide, go to objective and stuff. There's like a lot of things you can do in Commander Mode, because you gotta tell your teams what to do, where to go, and how to act. That's what I'm thinking. Battlefield 4 in whole general, it probably will be. It's like I can't really say it's gonna be the Call of Duty breaker or whatever they call it, but Battlefield 4 is just gonna be fun. Like I said, there's not gonna be no kill streaks. Medal of Honor had kill streaks, like because you had to do the buddy system and stuff, but I didn't really care. I wasn't into Medal of Honor that much. Battlefield 3 is where it's at. I probably will play Warfire sooner or later. I don't know yet. But Battlefield 3, like, yeah, it's gonna be objective and it's supposed to be fun. And I used to play it with my friend Marcus and Julian, and this game really does, well, sometimes, but yeah, it does keep you calm down from Call of Duty, because like you get frustrated when you go, you get frustrated and you probably will get be raging all the time. But if people really takes Battlefield 3 seriously, like they really trying to win, play the objective really carefully, then that's when they're trying to re yell out rage, tell them what to do, tell them completely so they can win. They have to tell yell at them to communicate with them, because like, well, sometimes I have to deal with that. I mean, that was one of the times, but I haven't done that a lot. But yeah, I usually take the mind off of Call of Duty and Battlefield 3 and just play this game. And next thing you know, I'm just saying, all right, let's go ahead and play some Battlefield 3, and let's go for kills and let's go hunting, whatever. Cause that's what usually comes up in my mind, saying, all right. And then if I were losing a match, I'll be saying, next thing you know, what the heck came out of my neck? So Yeah, that's basically it for yeah, guys. But excuse me, say yeah. I probably might leave some gameplay. Excuse me, gameplay music from Logic or G-Eazy or something. I don't know. Probably I will leave you some music for y'all to hear, cause this game is good. I probably will play some more. But like I said, this is a new series for the Road to Battlefield 4. It's gonna be coming probably sometime starting a week. And yes, I will have to do another update video for y'all because, excuse me, update video because next Friday is gonna be something different, and I'm gonna tell y'all in that video. So anyway, guys, if you hope I hope you did enjoy this gameplay on Battlefield 3, the way how I'm playing this game and stuff. On team deathmatch using UMP45, we did win. But anyway, guys, I hope you did enjoy. Subscribe if you're new to my channel if you want to see more Battlefield 3, or if you want to look at the Road to Battlefield 4. And I'll see you guys later. But anyway, as you know, toast out.
Some guys, they just hate for no reason. Gabish.
Hey, yo, six, this shit is crazy, right? You remember when we used to be in Lenny's basement and shit? And where we at? The come up.
Fuck your money, fuck your jewelry, fuck your cars, fuck all your bitches that you get. It's obsolete now. All that shit ain't fresh no more. Fuck all that.
On the rail, homie, on the rail, tell me how you feel. Everything I spit is gold, like I got a grill. Bet you people talking, thought I'd sell out once I got a deal. Still me and my team, only difference, we live in the hills. We live in the dream, these bitches perpetrating the skills. At the soup kitchen with my mama, they giving us meals. I was poor in my adolescence, but now I'm getting meals. Come on, tell me how it feels when that brand new record spills. Homie, this the come up. I'm from where them drug dealers are running. But I was never about that shit, I just worked to the sun up, boy, yeah. Claiming that they got